What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be an interview with Dimitris Samonos. He's the media person for Olympiakos, and me and him spoke about all the transfer drama, all that kind of stuff coming out of the club. So hopefully, guys, you enjoy this interview. Let's go.
It's agony, ecstasy, we're all one big family. We've got each other's back. We're the wolf pack. We're the wolf pack.
Part of the Reds. One player that can easily pass his opponent. He's very quick, very skillful. No matter who the opponent is, my feeling is that he can easily pass every opponent. Of course, he's a player not only with advantages. Of course, he has some disadvantages, such as I would say that sometimes he's unable to finish the chances that he creates. He cannot easily score. Although he can create a chance from nowhere, in the final effort, I think he needs to play better or to do better things. Olympiakos bought him some months before for 7 million euros from Sporting. And he also renewed his contract in Olympiakos. He still is one of the best players of the team. When everybody learned that Wolves made the proposal for Daniel Podence, the fans of Olympiakos, who are very demanding and want the best players for their team, didn't really want him to leave. Of course, the offer, as far as we know, is at about 25 million euros. I don't know if it is more. My information say that it is an offer at this level. If Podence finally moves to Wolves, it will be the biggest sale of Olympiakos in its history. Here in Athens, we believe that the transfer of Daniel Podence to Wolves would be sure. However, last night, after the derby of Olympiakos against AEK, we learned from the club that the deal or the imminent transfer collapsed. Until today, until this hour that we are speaking, we tried to learn the reason for this. In fact, we haven't come up to a conclusion of what might have happened, but we
Sorry, you went off then.
can you hear me now?
Yeah, just about. Yeah. Sorry about that. It's my internet.
Okay, maybe it's my fault. So we still try to learn the reasons for this. We come to the conclusion that it has to do with the money and possibly the way that Wolves would give this amount of money to Olympiakos. I still can't say for sure if the deal will go through. What I know is that tomorrow is a very important day for the final transfer. I think that the deal is not broken until now. There are still negotiations between the two clubs. This is my information. Today, the head of communication of Olympiacos, Mr. Nikos Gavalas, spoke to Sport 24 Radio here in Athens. And he didn't say, for example, that the deal is broken down. From what he said, we take the view that negotiations are still ongoing, and it's a matter of days to see what will finally happen. In fact, I can't speak to you with percentages. I can't say for sure what will happen. I am sure that Wolves want Daniel Podence. I am sure that Nuno Espirito Santo, who, by the way, have made a fantastic job at Wolves, I'm sure that he wants Daniel Podence. And I think that the board of Wolves wouldn't let him down. He would. They would try until the end to complete this transfer. I don't know if there's anything that you would like to ask, and I can help you.
Yeah, sure. I've got a few questions anyway.
Of course.
As you already know, there's a few Portuguese already in the squad anyway. The likes of Diogo Jota, João Moutinho, Ruben Neves, and an old teammate of his was Raul Patricio. Would you reckon if we do manage to sign him, do you think he would fit into our squad?
It's normal that since there are so many Portuguese players at Wolves, I am sure that Podence would fit much easier to this new environment. And I also am sure that Daniel Podence has spoken to his compatriots, who, by the way, have already met in their national team. Because, as you possibly know, Fernando Santos, the coach of Portugal, the manager of Portugal, have called Daniel Podence in their squad for some official games, although he didn't play. He didn't choose him to play. He stayed out of the squad. So I'm sure that Podence would fit in very well at Wolves with so many Portuguese players. And I think that these players have made the team much better. They have improved the image of the team in their games.
And I've got, well, you could say you've already answered most of my questions anyway. But the last question I've got is, what do you reckon the effect that Mendes has got? Obviously, being a high agent, known as he's an agent for Cristiano Ronaldo, most of the Portuguese players we've got in our squad. Do you reckon Mendes has had a massive effect on this transfer if it does come through?
Yes. Jorge Mendes is the agent of Daniel Podence. Of course, a powerful agent with so many contacts worldwide. I think he played a vital role at Wolves, Jorge Mendes. He's a person that has an excellent relationship with Olympiacos owner, Mr. Vangelis Marinakis. They have cooperated all these years, but this offer that probably Mr. Mendes brought to Olympiacos is the biggest in its history, as I said to you before. They have an. I think Mendes is the key element of this story. I am sure that he is the guy that the link between these two clubs. Although, as far as I know, today he was in Barcelona. Because he's there with the president of Valencia to complete the transfer of Rodrigo to Barcelona. As I said to you, I think that tomorrow is a vital day for the transfer of potential, though we have some days, in front of us until Friday. But I think that tomorrow we will know more. I just want to remind you that Podence, of course, knows everything. He comes from an injury, and for this reason, he didn't play in the last games, although now I think he's completely ready to play. He was one of the players for the squad against AEK, but the day of the derby, he stayed outside. He was not part of the 18 players. There were some rumors that he had already traveled to Wolverhampton, but nobody confirmed it. I think that Podence would like to come to play to Wolves. This is my feeling. I believe that he wants to play in Premier League. He thinks that it's a great opportunity for him to play in the best league of Europe. I don't say by this that he doesn't have a good time in Olympiacos, because he receives excellent money. During his presence in Olympiacos, he was called to his national team. He played in Champions League. Now he has the chance to play against Arsenal for the 32 of Europa League. But I think that these chances, these opportunities, do not come every day. I think it's a great opportunity for him, and I think for Wolves, because although he's not so, he doesn't have so much strength, which is needed in a Premier League, I think that he's so speedy, he has very good dribbling, and I think that he could help Wolves playing better in the right flank. I think he performs better in this position, although he can also play on the left. I think these two are the positions that he can play better. What else can I say to help you?
So you can play on the left and you can play on the right. Do you reckon you can give Traore a run for his money? Because I know Traore, as you can tell, at the moment, he's running rings around most teams. He's bought Real Madrid wanted him, loads of teams wanted him, Man City wanted him before. But do you really think he can get do you reckon he could play right wing above Traore, or do you reckon he could just be playing like more of a left winger?
Here in Olympiacos, this year he starts the games in the right wing. On the left, we have Masouras, one Greek national player. Pedro Martins, which is a Portuguese coach, sometimes changes these two players during the game, and Podence goes to the left wing. I don't think that he would have a problem playing in the as a left winger, but my feeling is that he could play better on the right wing. Of course, you have a very, very good player, Adama Traore, which he performs excellent playing as a right winger, and we also saw the game against Liverpool with his assist. But I think that he could also play on the left. I think Podence would really help Wolves. Many people question this huge offer for this player, but my feeling is that if he finally comes to play there and Nuno Espirito gives him the chance to play, I think that in the future, why not, he could be sold for much more money than this that he was bought from Wolves. And I think that if he continues like this, and of course, if he's healthy, I am sure that Fernando Santos will give him the chance to make his first appearance for the Portugal national team, a team with quality. But I believe that Podence has a role in this squad.
Well, thank you for your time anyway. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
It was also my pleasure, and we will see how this story goes. All the best for your team.
And you.
Bye. Have a good night.
And you. Bye.